First Vethism English Channel. Today I am going to present you the book on Thoughts of Periyar, compiled by Dr. K. Veeramani. Religion is the cause of injustice in the world. The reason why I have been often talking about religion is that during the time I have devoted for social welfare, I have learned that human progress is obstructed only by the activities carried on in the name of religion. It is said that everyone must have a religion. If that is right, the religion to which a man belongs must be able to bring him some practical benefits. But what we find in our country is that a man is bound to follow the convention of his religion, though that religion may be utterly useless to him in practical life. All religions, including Parsism, Christianity, Islam, Shaivism, Vaishnavism, and other subjects their followers to some restrictions. The followers of different religions whom I have met have all spoken about the compulsive rules and regulations of their respective religions. None of them has spoken about how he follows the moral principles of his religion. No religion advises followers to conduct themselves truthfully to the best of their knowledge. The people are only told that entertaining any thought against the principle of their religion is sinful. Expressing such a thought is irreligious, and making any attempt to get doubts clarified is atheistical. Therefore, a religion that allows its followers to conduct themselves according to the level of their understanding and their natural tendencies is very rare in the world. In fact, very few people understand the nature of the religion and the need for it. Those who follow a religion blindly because it is ancient and their ancestors followed it are in the majority. These people are totally ignorant of the implications of their religious practices and of the restrictions that are imposed on them. They do not try to understand the truth about their religion, but try to justify their attitude, saying that they must follow the practice of their elders, otherwise they would be committing a sin. The purpose for which religion claims to serve does not appear to be served at all. Asking a man, "What is your religion?" has become a formal question like, "Do you have your wife and children at home?" Or, "What is your educational qualification?" If we ask ourselves, "Why do we have religion? When did it arise? Is it permanent or frequently changeable? Or is it something which can be newly organized?" and think deeply about these questions, it will be clear to us that, like everything else in the world, religion or one's religious attitude is changeable. It cannot be said that a man's involvement in a particular religion is something permanent and that it cannot and should not change. According to the changing tones, some principles of social life are evolved to enable people to live together, and some people compel others to follow those principles which are conveniently called religious tenets. This evolved religion and is supported by concocted evidence and miracles. They might have been totally trusted in the past. The religious people of today do not care to examine whether the principles evolved in the past suit the present time. My final stand is this: for a man who aims at being serviceable to others without causing any convenience to them, religion is not necessary, and he does not need the Son of God, Nabi, Ajwas, Acharyas, Nair Mars, their sanctity and their miracles. I don't think that at present there is any religion which advocates social services. If anybody makes a deep search into old records and says that service-mindedness is advocated in them, I will only say that they are coaching from moth-eaten records and that no religion or community lay emphasis on service to others. In spite of there being so many religions and branch religions, none of them helps a man to live a happy and useful life. One who wishes to lead such a life will have to find some other means to help him. Unless this awareness comes to all people in a society, it will be difficult for them to live with mutual kindness and independence. We find new religion and new interpretations for the ancient religions coming up at frequent intervals, and countless discourses on these are going on endlessly, but nobody seems to devote time to consider how our society should be constituted and how far these religions and their interpretations will help our society. Thousands of people might have written about thousands of principles based on religions. We are not bothered about them. We can accept as truthful principle only that which is practicable and useful. The principles and restrictions which are imposed on people in the name of Shiva, Vishnu, Jesus, Nabi, Buddha, a Rishi or Manu, but which are difficult to practice in everyday life are not going to benefit the world at any time. Any religion which preaches doctrines which are contrary to human nature should be discarded. The problems and difficulties which human society is subjected to in the name of virtue, sin, religion, and moral principles are countless. I will firmly declare that all the injustices and anti-social activities found in the world take place only in the name of religion and God. Puranas and epics have recorded that religions and gods permit theft, debauchery, falsehood, murders, drinking and living lazy lives, exploiting the labor of others. They have also recorded that God has approved of these weaknesses and that He has also indulged into them. Thank you.
Please download Samaram multi-channel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.